short.
Are you too short?
Yes.
I think I'm too short too.
You are. So she couldn't reach that light.
No. And you know what? Listen up. You know what? All of us are too short to be what God wants us to be. What would I need to get up here to touch at?
A ladder.
A ladder. You know what Jesus is? He is a ladder between earth and heaven. And if we give our lives to Him, we can reach the glory of God.
Right. Let's everybody say it again because we're going to play a game.
I'm starting to
Boys against girls. Okay?
Romans 3:23.
real girl?
That's my twin.
All right. I got to use somebody besides his sister. All right, you want to come and help? Come and help. I'm going to tell you a Bible story, all right? Way back in Genesis, Bible said if God created the what? The heaven and the earth. And on the sixth day, God created what? Humans. And God created Adam. And God put Adam asleep, took out his rib, and formed Eve. Adam, there's your lovely bride, Eve. Wait a minute. Get back up here. Come on, come on. All right. You want to help me? Also, do you like fruit? There was all kinds of fruit trees. There was orange fruit trees and cherries and apples and pears and lemons and apricot and grapefruit and a plum and all kinds of trees. And God told Adam and Eve, you two can eat of any tree that you want to. All those trees were all around them. Except one tree. Does anybody know what that tree was? Not the apple tree, no. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil. God said, that's the only one. Now I got hundreds of fruit trees you can have, but only that one you can't get. And so one day Adam was over there working. Take him over there working. And Eve, oh, she woke up and she said, I want some fresh flowers for our little hut. Can you go over there and pretend to be picking fresh flowers? She's picking fresh flowers and smelling them and enjoying the beauty of the garden. And all of a sudden, somebody came into the garden, and that somebody went up to Eve and said, hello, Eve. Hello. How are you today? Those are beautiful flowers, aren't they? Well, I've been watching you. You've been out here for a long time, haven't you? You're probably getting hungry, aren't you? Yeah. Hey, have you ever noticed that tree over there? That tree looks good, doesn't it? Yeah. Won't you come over here with me? So the serpent took her over here to that tree. Don't you want a bite of that tree right there? And God said you could have a bite of that one? The tree of the knowledge? Oh, God said no. But can I tell you a secret? God's afraid you'll be as smart as him when you eat that tree. God's scared. Don't you want to be smart like God? That sounded pretty good to Eve. So you know what she did? Go over there and pick a piece of that fruit right there and eat it. Oh, no. Well, I'll see you later. I gotta go. Snake went away. And Eve went over to find Adam. Can you go find Adam? And Eve looked at Adam and said, well, hello, handsome. All right, so she don't have to. And Adam said, I've never seen that fruit. Where'd you get it? Oh, she says she got it from that tree over there, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And Adam was like, I know we're not supposed to eat it, but that looks so good and juicy. And he took a bite. And all of a sudden, when Adam and Eve took a bite, guess what? The glory of the Lord that surrounded them all of a sudden disappeared, and they felt dirty and yucky inside, and so they went and hid behind a bush. They went and hid. You know who visited Adam and Eve every day? God did, right? And one day, God came by, and he said, Adam! Eve! You seen Adam? You seen Eve? Adam! He went over there to the elephant. You seen Adam and Eve? Went over to the tiger. You seen Adam and Eve? Went over to the monkeys. Have you seen Adam and Eve? Went over to the giraffe. Have you seen Adam and Eve? Nobody. God kept walking. Went over to the little kitty cat. Have you seen Adam and Eve? Nobody has seen Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve! God peeked around the bush and said, Adam, Eve, did you eat of the fruit that I told you not to? Why don't you come out here? Did I not give you hundreds of fruit trees to eat from? Did I tell you you could not eat that one fruit tree? You two broke my rules, didn't you? And haven't you loved living in this beautiful garden? But you know what? Because I am a holy God and I keep my word, you two are going to get thrown out of my garden. Now Adam and Eve no longer had fruit trees when they woke up. And the only flowers Eve had is the ones she planted. And God put a big angel there with a sword at the gate of the Garden of Eden. But you know why God had to do that? Because who broke the rules? Adam and Eve. Do you think God's serious about sin?
Yes.
And about obedience? Right. So Adam and Eve broke the rules.
Who were the first people in the Bible to break the rules? Adam and Eve. And what tree did they eat off of?
The tree of the knowledge of good and evil. God didn't want them to have knowledge of evil. God don't want us to have knowledge of evil either.
No.
Let's all stand. I mean, why a six-year-old girl? Girl six? A girl five? Six, all right. Do I have a five-year-old boy? A six-year-old boy? Josiah, come ahead.
All right.
All right.
We're going looking for clues.
All right. If you got your magnifying glass, this is the song to bring it out, because we are going to look for clues.
Thank you.
other. God made us, everyone, unique and special.
He sure did. Now I want to tell you guys a true story. And this story is about a man who knew that he was going to rob a house, and he knew that he didn't want to leave his unique fingerprints.
No, when you rob a house, never leave your fingerprints.
So you know what he put on his hands? He put socks on his hands. He should have put gloves, but no, he put socks on his hands.
Wow, that's crazy.
So while he was robbing the house, the doorbell rang. It was the cleaning lady. The cleaning lady had came to clean the house. And so when the criminal opened the door, he forgot and left the socks on his hand. So the cleaning lady knew that that was not the owner of the house. She ignored the socks on his hand and pretended to sell the cleaning supplies. And after he told her he didn't want any, she left. She called the cops, and the cops came and arrested the man, and the man still had the socks on his hands.
He never took his socks off even when the cops came.
That was pretty silly of him.
That was.
Oh, no, that is so crazy.
So when he opened the door for the cleaning lady, he had the socks on. When the cops come, he still had the socks come. And you know what? When he stood before the judge, you know what sentence the judge handed out to him?
What?
It was a misdemeanor.
Oh, no.
Somebody didn't get that about midnight.
Oh, man. Even though that crazy guy left the socks on his hands and he was a criminal for robbing, you know what? Is it right to take something that doesn't belong to you?
No.
What rule would that be in God's rule book? What rule do you think that would be? Thou shalt not steal.
Right. That means your brother or sister's toys, too.
Yes.
Are you about ready to go back to school? That means your neighbor's pencil or eraser because you forgot yours and you just picked it up. Yeah.
Yep, that is stealing. So we need to be careful
what we do. Right. Well, let's stand. We have a song about that.
Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Well, be careful, little ears, what you hear. Be careful, little hands, what you ready. Be careful, little eyes, what you see.
Let me hear you sing.
Wednesday or Thursday? Joe Hartley, it's Sydney!
Whoa, Sydney!
Hi, guys!
week's day of creation, then we're going to have a test later on this week to see if you can remember what happened on each day. We're starting early here. Alright, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
Crash, bang, boom, heaven and earth.
And the earth was without form and void.
What do you like your hair?
Hey, Cindy.
Yeah.
My hair's fine. And God said, let there be light.
And he turned on the light switch.
No, Cindy, God didn't need to flip on a light switch. God just spoke the word, and light appeared. And God separated the light from darkness, and he called the light day, and he called the darkness what?
Power outage.
No. Some water down below in the form of the ocean and lakes and creeks, and then he made it be right in between of the clouds and the rivers.
He made a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
No,
that's not peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Oh, Cindy, God made the atmosphere, the air that we breathe in. Oh. And that was the second day. So what did God make on the second day? Clouds in the atmosphere that we breathe in. Then God gathered all the waters in one place, and he made dry land appear. And on that land, God made all kinds of plants to grow.
Like petunias and roses and lilies.
That's right, Cindy. It was like pop, 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 a tree here, a flower. And that was day number three. So what did God do on day number three? Made the plants. And then God made a great light in the sky.
It was called General Electric.
No, what was it, General Electric? What is that great light God made in the sky? The sun. You are right. Then God made a lesser light, and it was called the moon, right?
And I know what it was made out of. It's made out of cheese.
No, Cindy, the moon's not made out of cheese. The moon's made out of rock. And then not only did God make the sun and the moon that day, but he also made all the stars that shine in the sky.
Like me.
I was talking about the stars in the sky, Cindy, not you being the star.
Hey, I'm a star.
Well, anyways. And that was day number four. So what did God make on day number four? Sun, the moon, and the stars. Right. Then God made the fish in the sea.
There's something fishy about this.
And then not only did he make the fish in the sea, but he also made the birds flying in the air.
Hey, look! Oh, hey, bird, watch what you're doing!
Eagles. Ooh, you messed in your hair, Sydney. That was day number five. So what did God make on day number five?
Fish and the birds.
Donuts! You mean donuts!
No, that's not what he made on day six, Cindy. He made a man whose name was Adam and a woman whose name was Eve.
No, it was Myrtle.
No, it was Eve. Then God placed him in a garden, and just like he told them, he told them they could eat of any fruit tree in the garden except what?
Prune tree.
No.
I don't like prunes.
Oh, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
And prune trees.
Yes.
There's nothing
said what?
Want to buy a taco? With extra cheese.
No. He asked her. Sydney. He asked her. I hear you won't, God won't let you eat any fruit you want. But we can eat, but except the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, if we eat that tree, you will die.
Oh,
but,
yes.
Well, something like that.
I'm a great actor, ain't I?
But the serpent said, you won't die, Eve. God knows that if you eat of that fruit, then...
Your tongue will turn into a pickle.
Oh, your tongue will turn into a pickle? God said, if you eat that fruit, you'll be just like God. So Eve looked at that fruit, saw that it was good to eat.
Don't do it, Eve. Don't do it.
She reached up and picked that fruit.
Put it back, Eve. Put it back.
She took a bite of that fruit.
Spit it out. Spit it out. Her tongue will turn into a pickle.
And then she gave some of it to Adam. And then who came walking in the cool of the day?
Oh no, everybody hide!
And what did God say?